Okay. We good now? Sorry. The microphone wasn't working, but I got it working. Okay. Welcome in, everyone. Happy Thursday. Happy Thursday. I never know what day it is. Happy Thursday. Hope you guys are having a good one. We had a really small supper club today. It was just me and Jenny. Everyone was either working or out of town or whatever. So it was just Jenny and I, but we had a very lovely, long conversation talking about happiness, health, and a good home and all that stuff. It was really fun. It was a good conversation. Sometimes it's nice to just, I don't know, have a nice long talk with an old friend. It was really good. I had a good night. I hope you guys also had a very good night. What's up, Suki? My moon and my stars. Thanks for swinging in. I know it's god early there, but thanks for hopping in and saying hi. I appreciate you. Thank you very much for doing that. Always makes me feel so loved. Gabby! I can't feel my feet. What's up, nudes? Is today the day? Is today the day that you went apeshit crazy in your kitchen? Is it today? For some reason, no, it is. I think it was this week. How did all the cooking go? Or how is all the cooking going? It's gotta be crazy. Hope it went well, or is going well. We did our cooking today too. It was kind of a chill feed the hungry this week. I ended up having to dip into some of the stash that we had in the freezer. So I did a casserole. I did the millionaire casserole that we did a couple weeks ago that I froze. We ended up having to do that because I was gonna make a bunch of other stuff to go for this week, but considering we kept losing power last night and all that stuff, I didn't get nearly as much cooking done yesterday. I was hoping, yeah, mostly because of the power situation and other things. But we did 2 racks of ribs, 2 pounds of roasted broccoli, and nine cups of fried rice, and there's something else. Casserole, ribs, fried rice, broccoli. That's what we ended up donating today to the shelter. It was pretty good. Pretty good haul. It's over. I started yesterday. Okay, so it is over. You started yesterday, but now it's over. How long did you cook for straight? It's crazy. Did you take a nap in there somewhere? I'm so glad that Thanksgiving only happens once a year because the amount of cooking that I do on Thanksgiving is so exhausting. It's like cooking at least 3 days straight. I'm so glad it only happens once a year. Happy Thursday! What's up, True Sensitivity? How are you? Happy Thursday to you as well. Nice to see you. Happy hour. Happy hour to you as well, Army. Guess welcome in. What are you drinking tonight? Bourbon, because guess what we just got? Bourbon, because someone drank all the bourbon. This time it wasn't me. I did not drink all the bourbon. That was mostly Melon. That's a lot of food. What you're making is a lot of food. Throw another shot in there for me. Dude, Armagus, I don't know if I can put another shot in here. It's a pretty hefty pour already. Because it's a field trip stream and it's just, you know, drinking and having a cocktail and looking at food porn, I didn't want to have to get up and make another drink. So I made this one big and strong. Just how I like it. But there is already a shot in here for you. I named it the Armageddon Shop. I slept for 3 hours or so. Also, my hands felt like fire. Why? Did you burn them? I literally had to sanitize it to calm it down. What did you do to your hands? I've heard of like some extreme cooking before, but it sounds like Nudes did some crazy ass cooking. What on earth did you do? She's dumb though. She cooked, I can't even remember how many it was. It was a lot. What was the end count for you Nudes for how many meals you made? Anyone who doesn't know, every couple months, maybe like once a month, once every other month, Nudes ends up cooking for tons of people out of the goodness of her heart. Either her friends and family or her mom's coworkers and friends and family. Either way, like I think she made like 70 portions of food for people. Yeah, 70 plus, called it, right? It's insane. And she does this out of her own pocket, out of her own time, and just cooks these delicious meals and then individually portions them off and then goes and either has someone drive her or gets a rental-y thingy, but goes around and delivers all the food. absolutely an angel. Can't believe that. That's, I mean, I tried to do the thing where I delivered food to people, and it took me 2 hours just to deliver food to like 50 people. It was so, or more. It was way too much work. So that's why I'm really happy that I just donate all the food to one place and I make one trip. That's it. What am I doing? I got a Cook for Lana. Okay. Cook for Lana herd. We can start the stream off doing that. Oh, it's the chili heat. Ah, the chili heat was burning your hands, and so you had to sanitize them. I would imagine, wouldn't the chili heat make it more stingy? No? All right. Great to see you. What's up, Nikki Sachs? Welcome in. Nice to see you as well. You'll see it later from, oh, I can't wait to see the photos. Yes. I really want to see the photos. What were we doing? Lana heard her name. I gave Malin the rest of the bacon that I had cooked up. Oh, that's okay. We have this and this and this. I'm so glad to not be streaming from my phone today. It's nice to have my setup back. Meaning this whole thing. Trying to like read chat while on my phone was impossible. I have no idea how to raid. So thank you. I think it was Armageddon who raided me out last night. I don't know how to do anything on mobile. It's a pain in the butt. But we survived. Everybody's here. We's good. Oh yeah, kids will be here tomorrow too. I'm gonna go pick them up tomorrow afternoon, which will be exciting. Kids are gonna be super happy that I'm on a slightly new diet too, because it'll bode well for them. Good evening, Shelberto. How are you? Welcome in. Nice to see you. Welcome back. Alcohol calms down the heat, apparently. Really? Next time my hands are on fire because of spicy stuff, I too shall douse them in sanitizer and see how that works. How was the power outage? Ducky, it was okay. So the power went out 3 times. The third time was on stream, and then the power stayed recovered. And I never actually followed up with the power company or read anything on like why that all happened. But yeah, anyone who doesn't know, I lost power 3 times last night. 2 of them happened on stream, to the point that we just did the rest of the stream on my phone because I was just waiting for the power to go out one more time. Luckily it didn't. And we were streaming from my phone, but luckily my lights were working. But there's a couple points in there where my lights weren't working, and were we chopping watermelon in the dark? I think we were chopping watermelon in the dark. It's pretty funny. Oh, hi, what's up, Mama Silva? It's been a while. Nice to see you. Welcome back in. How are you? Happy Thursday. Hope all is well. We're about to do a field trip where we're going to go look at food porn together. What do you guys think? 1 slice of deli meat or 2? She's a pretty good puppy. Maybe we'll give her 2 slices. Citrus like lemon juice does that too. Really? Everything you guys are saying sounds really painful to me. If I had chili on my hand and it was burning, the last thing I would want to do is put citrus on it. But if you guys say that it works, when I am desperate to alleviate the pain, I will do whatever you guys say. So, all right, we'll do it. At midnight, I just chose the bed method. Okay, that works too. Yeah, congratulations, Nudes, on cooking 70 plus servings of delicious, was it a beef noodle soup? Spicy beef noodle soup for all those people. Okay, we'll do, we'll just, Lana can have one and then I'm gonna have a piece too. Mama Silva says, doing okay, I twisted my bad knee last week, so I have to wear a stabilizer for 4 to 6 weeks. Oh no, I'm so sorry. That sucks. When I was mostly in high school, I had a tendency of breaking or re-breaking or re-tweaking a broken ankle that I had on my right foot. So I ended up breaking this foot 3 times and then this foot 2 times. And really it was one bad injury that kept re-breaking or like never fully healed right. And then whenever I would try to compensate with this foot, by compensating, I then ended up fucking up my other foot. So my ankles are totally messed up. And for most of high school, I was either in a brace or I was in another cast. Like most of high school, I swear to God, I was on crutches. I feel your pain. But I hope you have a quick, swift recovery. Yeah, that's another reason why. So we are starting to do this thing, which I'm so proud of. Melon is relinquishing his control, and we're starting to contract out some of the stuff that we do around the house, like DIY. Usually Melon like will do the gutters and the roof and all the landscaping and the tree trimming, everything he does himself. Because it's like half the cost that it would be if we hired a professional. But we're just now starting to accept our age, and that when we get injured, it takes longer for us to heal, and that we're more injury prone the older we get. So we're actually hiring someone to do the roof now. And I told Malin, like, just think about it this way. By hiring someone to clean the gutters and demoss the roof, just imagine the medical bill you're going to save if you fall off the roof, right? So, I'm going to go with that we're saving money in the long run by hiring a professional. Because with Malin's, like, you fucking fall off the roof. I survived on Coke and coffee infusion. Ah, that is the way to go. Having to cook all of that food. Oh, my Lord. Coke and coffee? Those are your vices? Well, pretty good. I'm actually drinking Coke right now. I'm doing rum and Coke right now. I thought I'd mix it up. I realized I've been in a rut, I think since New Year's. I've been in a rut, just like overwhelmed, higher anxiety than usual. Not from streaming, but from just like life and stuff. And I think dieting was not helping me. And so the other day, like a day or two ago, I gave myself permission to eat whatever I wanted. Also, my tummy condition has gone terrible. Like, my meds don't work anymore, and everything I eat upsets my stomach. So I am now just eating anything I want in small portions. And it's actually boosted my mood recently. Like, I ate ramen like 2 days ago, and I was just so happy. And then today, Jenny made me a sushi bowl, like a sushi bowl for a supper club. And it was like tons of rice, and I ate it all. Like, I'm very happy right now, just enjoying whatever I want to eat, being happy, enjoying my vibe. The little things in life, I think I'm trying to focus more on being happy, and I think in turn that's going to help my health. I also have a checkup with my doctor on Monday, so we'll see how my liver is. I already got the blood test, so he already has a result, so hopefully no permanent liver damage. We'll see. Where's my bowl? There's my bowl. But yes, right now, it's all about focusing on being happy and healthy. And now you have the quality time together instead of hard labor. Yeah, well, quality time, Shelberto, I don't know. The time he would have been doing cleaning the gutters and the roof, he's just going to be playing video games or sleeping. That's pretty much Malin's, like, MO. I think it's because he works really long hours. He works a lot. And so the way he decompresses is usually watching weird shit on YouTube, like Russian car accident dash cam videos. He'll binge watch that for, like, no shit, 8 hours straight on YouTube. He'll do that on a sunny Saturday afternoon, or he'll play video games. But no, I don't think he's going to be, like, snuggling with me in bed. But still, as long as he's not in the ER, we're good. A lot of my injuries are from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu wear and tear. Is Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu the same as capoeira or not? Because I heard someone say it's not the same, and then I heard a lot of people say it is the same. Like, oh yeah, capoeira, that's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. And then someone else was like, no, those are actually two separate things. So, Mama Silva, you can be the final say in, is capoeira Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu or not? Also, badass. I'm sorry to hear that you have so many injuries from it, but that's pretty badass. If I could choose, which I know I can't, but if I could choose what physical extracurricular activity my kids got into, I would really, 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 really want them to do martial arts. I did not do tennis, golf, basketball, volleyball, soccer, baseball, softball. I did not do any of those sports. I did kendo, so I did martial arts as a little girl. And I really, really want my kids to do it, but I'm not going to force them. Right now, Jace actually shows an interest in doing Taekwondo, which my mom will be so thrilled if he chooses Taekwondo. But it's because he saw it in a Cocomelon cartoon, and they're like, Taekwondo will take you far. Anyways, now he's got the Taekwondo Cocomelon song stuck in his head. And so he's like, Mama, can I do Taekwondo? And I was like, yes, you can do Taekwondo if you want. And I was like super excited. But Malin doesn't want Jace to do martial arts until he's a little bit older, because he's afraid Jace is just going to go around punching and kicking stuff. And I told him that the martial arts instructors know how little kids are and will teach them appropriately. Like, they're not idiots. Like, they're not going to teach our kid to just, like, go and punch everything. Like, they're trained to deal with kids. I do agree, though, that Jace is a little bit young to do it right now. Plus, I think the minimum age for most martial arts is, like, 6 years old. So Jace still has another year. But, man, I hope he does Taekwondo. And I really hope Lena does Kendo. But, again, all I can do is introduce them and see what happens. I thought ballet would be kind of cool, too. Malin is really hoping for soccer, I think, is the one, because he wants to coach the teams. And we'll see if that happens. But the funny thing is, out of all four kids, the only one that might have, like, an aggressive fighting spirit and athletic talent, all of our hopes and dreams are pinned on the two-year-old. Lena is our only. Amaya has the fighting spirit, but she's very athletic, but she kind of doesn't really want to do sports. Carter has the athleticism, but he has no fighting spirit. Like, he's not very competitive at all, except for video games. And even then, it's more like he just likes to troll people. And then Jace has neither a fighting spirit nor any athleticism at all. My kid is the kid who, like, goes to kick a ball and then, like, swings, whiffs, and falls down. That's my five-year-old. Lena is very coordinated and very strong-willed and very athletic, even though she's only two. She's the only one that has everything, but she can't talk or have any sort of functional communication. So I want to put her in a sport or some sort of, like, early tumblers class, but no person is going to take her. No teacher is going to accept Lena in a class or anything, but maybe when she's older. I'm excited. Really, really hope Lena does martial arts. Oh my God, so fucking cool, little badass baby. All right, guys, you need to let me know the next time a keto cheat day happens. Tomorrow? I'm gonna talk to my doctor on Monday, but I think I'm off keto because it was really helping for a while. And then something happened starting January. I don't know what. It's just the way flare-ups work with UC. Nothing works anymore. Nothing. Like, I literally spend half my day in pain and agony and torture. It's terrible. So, yeah. The only thing is, I can only eat, like, 4 to 5 ounces of food at a time. That's it. And I could only have, like, max 3 or 4 meals a day. I just can't take any more food than that. The pain is too much. So, but I mean, I gotta eat something. So yeah, bring it on. Whatever you guys want me to eat, I'll try. Malin still says he wants to do keto, but because I'm eating whatever I want now and he sees what I'm eating, like, I made myself this epic sandwich and he's like, can I have one of those? And so I made him one, then he wanted another one. And then just like 10 minutes ago, he asked for another one. So Malin's also cheating on keto, but we might go back to it. I'm not doing keto right now, though. You have great Cajun ingredients. So many Cajun dishes aren't keto-friendly. We just love rice too much. Hey, guess what I had for lunch or guess what I had for dinner tonight? Rice. So, yeah, let's go, Armageddon. I also think part of my rut is I think I just burned out on, like, eating healthy or just eating keto. I think I just burned out. Just was eating the same stuff too much. I was cooking a lot of food, but I wasn't eating the food I cooked. It was all going to the shelter or to friends and other people. I think I just missed food. I missed, like, fucking pasta and shit. And now that there are no consequences one way or another, like, I'm fucked no matter what I do. So, yeah, let's go eat, like, carbs all week long. Why not? Fuck it. Let's go. Kathy's alive. Hey, doggy. Kathy's alive. What's up, Splits? Welcome and nice to see you. How are you? Okay. I was hungry. I had double the normal portion of rice. Yum. Did you mention martial arts? Yes, I grew up doing kendo. My brother did taekwondo. My other brother did Shaolin. So yeah, whole martial arts family here. I kind of want to do Krav Maga too. Okay, I was hungry. Yep. Taekwondo focuses on flashy kicks. Yes, taekwondo is also Korean, which is why my mom is going to be thrilled if Jace chooses to do taekwondo. Because if he really gets competitive, then my mom will take him to Korea in the summers to train in Korea under like top tier people. So when I did kendo, that was kind of what the fancy kids did if you could afford it. And also a lot of my friends were Japanese or half Japanese. And so they had relatives or family friends in Japan. So the thing was many summers, all of the teens would go travel to Japan and they would just do kendo all summer in dojos in Japan. And so if Jace wants to do the same thing for taekwondo, like luckily for him, his grandma lives in Korea during the summer and so he can go visit there. And also I still have like my aunt and my uncle live in Korea still. So if he wants to do taekwondo, that's awesome. If he wants to do kendo or like a Japanese martial arts, my sister lives in Japan, so technically he could go visit her, I guess. But yeah, I think it's super cool if you can go back and train there. No, says Mom Silva, it's different. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is more ground fighting and submission holds. Capoeira is a Brazilian martial arts that combines elements of dance, acrobatics, music. Thank you. Okay, so it's not the same. We're going to take it from the person who actually does it. Everyone always says capoeira is Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. No, similar, they are two separate things. Thank you for the clarification, Mama Silva. We appreciate you. But yeah, really, really big fan of martial arts in general. I think they teach a lot of the same things that people say, oh, I learned this from doing sports, like being part of a team and like work ethic and hard work and all this sort of stuff. When I did kendo, I was also on a team. So you do a lot of one-on-one sparring matches, but they do five-on-fives in tournaments. And so I was on a team, even for UW, I was on the team for the University of Washington, and we had a collegiate tournament where we actually went to Harvard and we kicked Harvard's ass. It's pretty awesome. And the West Coast dominated first, second, and third place, all West Coast schools. It was pretty cool. But yeah, you still learn a lot about sportsmanship and teamwork and all that stuff on a martial arts team as well. Did I mention I've been studying martial arts for over 20 years? Splits, I don't think you did tell us. What martial arts do you do? What kind of martial arts do you do? Yeah, I don't care what martial arts my kids do. I just hope they get into martial arts because I'm biased. That's what I did and that's what I really enjoyed. And I don't know. Don't tell Malin I said this. I think it's so much cooler than soccer. Soccer is cool, sure. Martial arts is cooler. Whatever they want to do, I'll get them in. I want to get Jason to taekwondo though. I think he'd really like taekwondo. We'll see if he wants to do it. All right, it's almost 11 o'clock. Shall we start our field trip? Anyone who doesn't know, every Thursday we get together, we have a cocktail, and we look at food porn together. This is what we do. And it's in our exclamation point Discord under the food pics section. We'll go through all the pictures that have been posted since last week when we were here. And last week we ended on St. Patrick's Day. And so, we have some posts here for that. So everyone get your cocktail, get comfortable, take a sip, and let's look at some food porn. Okay, I already am looking at this one. Ooh, I didn't check to see if my setup was working. I'm smart though, I remember to get my second monitor out. Look, it's working! Okay, we got everything good? Yeah, we good? Everything here? Alrighty, let's pull up Discord so I can tell what I'm reading. This one. Mama says, I am a third degree black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Nice! I never made it past first degree. I started doing kendo when I was 8. But I took so many long breaks and I had so many injuries, I never really got past first degree. Master Split says, I am a third degree black belt in Taekwondo and a blue belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. What? I'm also the 2005 Canadian National Champion and 2013 Bronze Medalist. Oh my God, Split, that is super cool. Congratulations on all your achievements. That's really awesome. 2005 Canadian champion. Oh, all right, that's pretty fancy, it's pretty fancy. Damn it, I wanted to redeem Cook for Lana just to fuck with you. It's already done. We already did the Cook for Lana. She had deli meat, Tillamook cheddar cheese, and an egg. She's pretty happy. So cool. Yeah, two people who do Brazilian jiu-jitsu. That's awesome. Oh, that's Alice's photo. It is nudes. It is Alice's photo. What did Alice say? She said for St. Patrick's Day. She actually spelled Saint out for a second there. I was like, I didn't recognize it. For St. Patrick's Day, I made a whole chicken that I brined. Ooh, I want to hear her brining tips. That I brined, then roasted. Poutine with beer battered deep fried cheese curds. Holy shit. Let's say that again. Poutine. Okay, got it. With beer battered deep fried cheese curds. Beer battered deep fried cheese curds. That sounds extremely... She took a Canadian dish and hella made it American. Beer battered, deep fried cheese curds. That's very American sounding. Oh, yeah. Oh, Aura gets you panda cracker. For general purposes. Oh. Why would you do this? You know it slows... You want me to scroll with my nose, don't you? Anyone who's seen me panda bear or mama bear before while I was following a recipe on my phone because Malin was at the helm, I had to scroll using my nose, and I think that's just what Army Guts wants me to do. Split says, I haven't been training for 2 years because of the pandemic. I've been stretching and exercising at home to maintain my flexibility and fitness. Ooh, that's so cool. That is super cool. Oh my gosh. I never did Taekwondo. Kind of wish I would have. It would have been nice to do a Korean martial arts. I think my mom would have been more supportive of my doing martial arts had it been a Korean one, but I did a Japanese one and she never flipped me too much shit about that, but yeah, yeah. That's super cool though. Maybe I should, so when Lena goes to preschool, both kids will be in preschool for 2.5 hours, 4 days a week. And so part of me was thinking I should use that time to see if I could find like a fitness class, do like bar or yoga. Oh shit, computer. Ah, Armageddon. Computer, set bear timer for 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
You almost got me again. Almost. Mm. But yeah, I looked around and there's like one class that is available in my general area. And it's only on Mondays and Fridays. And it costs a lot of money. It's like $200 a month. For 8 classes, I don't know if I'm gonna pay that. I might, and I don't know if there's any martial arts studios that are open during that time. I don't know if I wanna do like Krav Maga at 10 in the morning. I don't know. But I'm gonna look into doing something more athletic while both kids are at school. I would love to learn from you. Ooh, that sounds so cool. But I really miss martial arts, so Splits. Hope I won't lose much when I, no, it'll be like riding a bike. You got this. Seriously, 3% salt, 3% brown sugar by weight for all of your brining purposes. Is it okay? You don't have to credit me. I'll know. I know. When I said I wanted to learn all of her brining secrets, that was the first thing that popped in my head was Armageddon always uses sugar, specifically brown sugar, when brining, and I've never done that. I always use salt and then other herbs and spices, but I don't think any of the ones I've There might have been one, like an Alton Brown one that used sugar, but most of the ones I ever brine with never use sugar, but I've heard vehemently from Armageddon that it is the way to go. So we can brine some chicken in the next couple days. We have a lot of chicken in the freezer. Hi, Mary Todd, welcome in, how are you? I'm trying to scroll with this. We have a second mouse now because the one that Malin got me for my birthday sucks and it keeps dying. So I got the old mouse out. All right. So, okay. I'm sorry. I didn't even finish reading Alice's. So Alice did, I got caught up on the poutine. Poutine with beer batter, deep fried cheese curds, potato and cabbage soup with bacon. That must be down more. And a loaf of bread that started out as Irish soda bread, but was decidedly not when I was done with it. And a garlic and sun-dried tomato compound butter. Holy crap. I forgot. Is Alice a professional chef? Because she sure as hell sounds like it. Okay. Beautiful. I can't do any zooms because I have my bear paws on, but I can try. Just scroll down. Okay. Scroll. Scroll. Ooh, okay. Let me roll and click. Fuck you. Damn it, Armageddon! It's like trying to hit a needle with a smaller needle. Haha! Got it! Take that. Okay. Oh my god, now I gotta click away so I can read it. Alright. Scroll down and click. Aha! Oh, okay, so this is a bacon and cabbage soup. I can't scroll up again. Hi, Mary Todd, welcome in. Split says, had I sat on the couch eating junk food all day for the last 2 years, that would be different, right? Yes. Then you'd be more like me right now. Though I didn't eat junk food, but I did not eat. I don't know. I still gained. Well, most of mine was streaming every night and drinking too much. But I did gain 10 pounds in the pandemic. Straight up. I totally gained 10 pounds. I was already 10 pounds overweight, so now I'm 20 pounds overweight. So I'll have to work on that. But it could have been worse. It could have been a lot worse. But I think everyone kind of, everyone gained what did we call it? The quarantine weight? Everyone gained quarantine weight. Fun fact, the original Power Rangers actually got me into wanting to do martial arts, as I like this style of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, so I chose that style instead of the others. Oh, that's so cool! Fuck yeah, Power Rangers! Who was your favorite Power Ranger? Mine was Trini. I also like the Pink Ranger, Kimberly. And I think I had a crush on Tommy, the Green Ranger. But yeah, let's go. Sugar by itself does give the meat the moisture you expect. Salt kicks it up another notch. Oh, I've never brined something with just sugar before, but I like this salt-sugar combo idea. It sounds great. And I like that it's brown sugar because I feel like that's more umami. Does brown sugar have more umami than white sugar? Is there umami in sugars? I don't know, but I think it tastes better. I love when people say they want to learn from me. Aw, the love. That's awesome. You're a third degree. I'm only a blue belt with 4 stripes. So splits. Sounds like a good idea. You should totally. Do you guys have like meetups? So in kendo, it was really common for people to travel to other dojos if we were all in the same AUSK of all. Was it all United States Kendo Federation? AUSKF? Yeah. Anyways, and if you were in part of the Kendo Federation, all the different dojos. I mean, some of them were kind of. They had beef with each other, but for the most part, everyone, if you're in it, like, you were allowed to travel to any other dojo and be a guest there, and so that would be really cool if Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu was the same, if there was, like, a federation that you paid dues to, but it allowed you to visit any other dojo and, like, spar there. That'd be pretty cool. Take a gallon of water, add 113.55 grams of salt and 113.55 of brown sugar. Marinate for 8 to 20 hours. That's a very vague window. Overnight. 8 to 20 hours is overnight, depending on how much you sleep. Gotcha. Mine was also Trini. Wasn't she the best? She was scared of heights. It's okay. I get it. I was a little scared of heights then, too. I had a huge crush on Kimberly. Everyone had wasn't her name Amy Jo Johnson? Yeah, everyone had a crush on Kimberly. It wouldn't result in a bad result, but it does have less flavor, Mary Todd's saying. I've used just white sugar. Is that okay? Yeah. Not the same, but yeah, that totally works. Power Rangers are a bit young for me. Does Scooby-Doo count? I don't think Scooby-Doo did martial arts, but sure, Scooby-Doo can count too. Scooby-Doo, if you want to get your kids into horror movies or get them to like scary movies when they're older, the trick, apparently, or so I've been informed, is to get your kids watching Scooby-Doo at a young age. And if you think about it, you're like, yeah, that makes sense. If you want your kids in the future to like scary movies, get them into Scooby-Doo. So I'm going to work on that with Jace. If anything, Jace is the one that needs to learn to, like, yeah, he's way more sensitive than Lena. Lena's favorite toy is a ruler. Who did that?
Thank you.
This is my heart. Thank you, Anonymous, for that $6.66 donut. Ferta kits, since we were talking about health earlier, thank you for providing the IV drop tubing kit for the patients at St. Jude Children's Hospital to receive their treatment. That's the line, the IV, the water, the medications, everything. And they usually, like, hook them up to the radio flyer wagons while they, like, bomb through all the halls and stuff. So thank you for giving the children the conduit in which for them to receive their medication and their treatment to heal up and to kick cancer in the motherfucking ass. So thank you so much, Anonymous, for that very generous, devilish dono. On behalf of us in the AFK Kitchen, our team, the Good Cause Crusaders, and the patients, parents, and providers at St. Jude Children's Hospital, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Power Rangers are a bit young for me. Ooh, but they're so good. I wouldn't say brown sugar has umami, says Werel, but it certainly has more flavor than plain white sugar. Yeah, that's what I was like. I don't know if umami's the word, but you're right. Flavor, the molasses adds flavor. Lately, my brines include Chef Steve's butt rub. Oh my God, Mary Todd, thank you so much for reminding me. I have to stock up. I don't know how, but in the past year, I've gone through 5 pounds. I think it's all together. I've had 5 pounds of Chef Steve's butt rub. I put it on everything and I am almost out. I actually might officially be out. So I need to go order some more Chef Steve's butt rub. Thank you for the reminder. I think mysteries more so. Mysteries! But I think it's the fact that there's something scary in the movie, like, or in the TV show for Scooby-Doo. It's the monster or whatever. Why? I'm still on my hand over my heart. It's the monsters and then the unveiling of them. I think it's like teaching kids that things that are scary, like, it's all fake. And so even in a movie, when you see like this, like, it's still an actor under a mask. So I think it's the demystifying scary things and realizing, like, at least when you watch movies, that everything is fake. Because even in the TV show, there was a dude wearing the mask. So I think that's why. But I do like the fact that there's a mystery to solve and that critical thinking, getting them to think, like, why is that? Like, Scooby-Doo is fucking really good for kids. The more I think about it, the more I'm like, my kids need to watch Scooby-Doo for educational purposes. Critical thinking, demystifying scary things, friendship, teamwork. Yeah. I feel like Scooby-Doo is educational for kids. Hey, I just heard a bunch of ice clink downstairs. You know what that means? That means Malin is fucking learning, or he's way too lazy to come upstairs. He is in the middle of a D&D campaign right now, but I just heard him top off his ice using the downstairs ice. That's what we call personal growth. Computer, off. Thank you for that, Armageddon. I like Scooby-Doo, but I hate, am still terrified of scary movies. Oh, okay, so it doesn't work for everyone. It's not saying that it's gonna cure you of scary movies, but it helps for some people. Oh, okay, so this is the soda bread that started out as Irish soda bread, but was decidedly not when I was done with it. And then last but not least is the compound butter. I think it was roasted tomato, what was it? Sun-dried tomato compound butter to go on the not Irish soda bread. Split says, does stretching and exercising help when I return to martial arts? Yes. How much it helps? Who knows? But it's better than not doing it, for sure. Just in general, stretching and exercising just helps you stay healthy, right? You know that. You're a martial artist. So as long as you're staying limber and you're keeping your body in not couch potato shape, then yeah, you'll get far less injuries than everyone else when they return to the studio and they're all pulling muscles and shit. Yeah, staying limber is awesome. Good on you. What's the next one? Next one is nudes. Ooh. It's fun now because I've said fuck it to diets in general right now. It's so fun because when I see something that's like, oh my God, I think I want to eat that. Guess what? Now I can because I just don't give a shit anymore. So I am so excited about eating some dumplings. I'm going to eat some motherfucking dumplings. I think on Monday I'm going to make breakfast burritos, but instead of breakfast burritos, I'm gonna make breakfast egg rolls. So hash browns, sausage, eggs, wrap them up in an egg roll wrapper. Fuck, maybe I'll do that tomorrow. And then if Malin gets the midnight munchies, he can have that for a snack. If I am rusty, then a few weeks of training and I'll be fine. Yeah, for sure. So when I quit kendo, multiple times due to injuries and whatnot, I usually had a couple weeks where I like my form was a little off. I had to like tweak some stuff. But like there was times where I took a 2-year break and I came back and within a couple weeks I was more or less back to where I was. Sometimes taking a big break actually helped me because I had my footwork was not really great. Some of my basics, my foundation was not. I was always in a rush to like work my way up, and so some of my like I could slap in a hit and it would count as a point, but it wasn't good form necessarily. So that ended up catching up with me. The higher ranks I got was the lack of good basics fucked me over the higher rank I got. So sometimes it was good to take a break because I would always go back to basics and start all over again. So in some ways, it's actually good to take it. I think it sometimes there are added benefits of taking breaks from a sport or martial arts because it does. It brings you back to basics. You start over again. And it's kind of a nice clean slate to work yourself up. And anything that you were struggling with before, for me, it was always footwork. Because I kept fucking up my ankles. It was always good when I had a clean slate because I could just focus on my footwork and try to get a better foundation. Scooby-Doo can also teach them formulaic storytelling. Okay, that's very... So can Sailor Moon. Sailor Moon will tell you that. Get yourself some Xiaolong Bao. Add some cheese to that. Dude! God, it's going to be so much work, but maybe we should do it. Maybe we should make some more pho Xiaolong Bao because I made it last year and it was probably one of the best things I've ever made in my life. And Malin didn't get any because I was using the leftover gelatinized pho broth that Robert made. And there was only like this much left. So it was just enough to make maybe 8 Xiaolong Bao. And Malin wasn't here that night when I made it and I ate all of them. I didn't even save it one. So maybe if I'm a really nice wifey poo, we'll make some pho Xiaolong Bao for Malin. Lol, a distant Malin is heard. Yeah, you guys can hear him downstairs. He's doing D&D campaign right now. Wait, isn't cocktail date with Jen tomorrow? Tomorrow, yes. What did I say? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, so we're not doing egg rolls. Oh, my God, I gotta text Jen back. Yes, Jen and I are moving the cocktail date till tomorrow. Because today with field trip and supper club and feed the hungry, my Thursdays are swamped. So I asked her to postpone until tomorrow. I think we're gonna do some Tolkien drinks. And we'll do trivia at the very end of stream. It might be a late trivia. It just depends on how Jen and I are feeling. You guys know me. I don't really ever plan ahead. We just wing shit. You should try mini waffle. Oh, wait. You should try mini waffle in that breakfast egg roll. That's a good idea. This is, for anyone I didn't read out loud yet, this is Nudes' signature beef la mian and dry handmade dumplings. Ooh, I like the sauce on them. The sauce looks good. I see some cilantro. Very nice. I like the color. Ooh, look at them nudes. Oh, that looks tasty. It looks also light and refreshing, but lots of flavor. Let's go. My cousin wants me to cater for her in the future. Ooh. Nudes, is that something you want to do? Are you into catering? Because I agree. I think you'd be a great caterer. Also, she nearly cried eating my food because she was having a bad day. She forgot she was going to get food from us. Oh, my God. I'm the owl between you and Jen. I love it. Yes. Nudes is our messenger owl. I love it. I mean, she did text me, but I had kind of a crazy day. I texted her back. And then I was like, yeah, that sounds like a great idea. And I never followed up. So, I'll text her tomorrow morning or tonight when I finish up stream. Don't mind my squeaky chair. That's so cool. I think that'd be really fun. If you're into catering needs, that's a great idea for a future thing. If you have anyone down in Houston, Texas, the original Green Ranger team. Whoa, back the man. What? If you have anyone down in Houston, Texas. Maybe. We have a lot of people in chat who are from Texas. The original Green Ranger, i.e. the one I had a crush on, teaches martial arts. Oh my God, are you able to get a spot in his class? Because I feel like he's blowing every other studio out of the water, right? I feel like he's got to be super ridiculously popular and his classes are really expensive. And all the moms who drop their kids off at his class are probably just sitting there on the sidelines, like, checking him out. I can't do it myself. I'm so dead from this already. Well, you can get, like, like a helper. You can get a helper to do catering with you. Maybe. I think that'd be kind of fun as like a side hustle. Shadow made some Cajun shrimp deviled eggs, minced up the shrimp, seasoned them with Chef Paul Prudhomme seafood magic. That sounds very Southern. Creole seasoning, pink salt, and sauteed in butter, and mixed it into the deviled egg mix, dusted with paprika. Also had Mortal Kombat printed Guinness. I saw this and I have no fucking idea how this happens. Okay, deviled eggs look amazing. Well done, Shadow. I fucking love deviled eggs. Also, what the fuck is this? How does one have a Mortal Kombat? Wait, how do I scroll out? How does one have a Mortal Kombat printed Guinness? I don't understand how you do that. It's not like when you do the latte art with the leaf. How do you do that? How do you print on the foam? How does one print foam? Mama Silva says, can I post the link? Yes, you can. I would put it in exclamation point Discord. Just post it in the random section. If it's about the guy who's the Green Ranger, you should post it in random and I will check it out because that sounds interesting. And that's with Granny's help of most things. Like peeling onions. Dude, no one... Peeling onions and peeling garlic. Oh, you always need someone to help you with that. You need someone to do your bitch work. I'm not saying have your granny do your bitch work. I'm just saying have someone do your bitch work. Because onions... Oh, chopping onions, peeling potatoes, and peeling garlic. Nobody ever wants to do that. Shadow, this is like the coolest shit I've ever seen. Malin is going to lose his shit when I show it to him. Also had a Mortal Kombat printed Guinness. This is not something that she found on the internet. This is something she got to drink and I'm super jealous. I literally bought peeled pineapple too. That's funny. Hello, just got here. Welcome in retro, how are you? I buy peeled garlic. Yeah, so do I. I always buy peeled garlic. Ain't nobody got time to peel garlic. Okay, I do have a garlic press though. Ooh, Paxi, what is this? Let me zoom in. Wait, how do I do zoom? Ahaha! Okay, we're gonna get a little bit bigger. All right. A little love goes a long way. Organic fusion tea house, complete with shark Lego. What did Paxi say? Went out with a friend for lunch, got a passion tea with rainbow jelly and chow mein and crispy toast. Oh, there's rainbow jelly. That's a bubble tea. I didn't recognize the cup. But this is, you can see, rainbow jelly. I usually don't get rainbow jelly because I'm not sure if I like the texture. I like lychee jelly and pineapple or coconut jelly better, but it's nice. I like the little shark dude. Okay, and the next one is chow mein and crispy tofu. Ooh! I'm about to put some of this in my stummy. My stummy is my stomach tummy. So that is the crispy chow mein nudes. Oh, look at that. Got a little color there on the chicken. Nice. What is up here? What are those? Are those fried or those baked? What are they? They look like tiny grilled cheese sandwiches or something. I don't even know, but they look delicious. It costs more, but hell if I'm peeling them. That's my thought too. It does cost more. It costs way more to buy pre-minced or pre-peeled garlic. There's a couple brands that have a weird funny taste because when you peel it, it goes bad faster. And so they use like some sort of like preservative-y thingy on it. So some of them taste really bad. They have a weird funky after flavor, but the minced garlic that I get from the Korean market, it just tastes like minced garlic. There's like no funny taste to it. So I always get that one. But the one that I get at the American grocery store definitely tastes weird. Mary Todd says, I put my young moose in front of my driveway in random last night. Okay, remind me that at the end of the field trip. There was a young moose in front of your driveway and you took a picture of it? That's kind of awesome. Nice. I've never seen a young moose before. What is this? So this is from Trash Panda. Oh, nice. This is a Persian cucumber yogurt. It's called a Mast o Kira chicken with rice. I really, really like this idea. Okay, so you got, that looks like dill. So it kind of reminds me of like tzatziki sauce, had a baby with some rice and chicken, which sounds amazing. Good God. Oh, that sounds really good, right? Right? Tzatziki sauce, chicken, rice, mix it all together. I'm guessing that's because it's cucumber yogurt, so it sounds similar. So I see dill. There's a little bit of cucumber right there. That little piece of chicken. Nice. That looks like creamy, delicious goodness. I would eat the shit out of that. Oh, it's a video. Thank you, Mary Todd. Pre-peeled garlic. I buy only one brand, one shop with the do not eat packs. Ah, okay. Sounds good. Once you find out what you like, that's how you go, whoa. Oh, this is a throwback. All right. Nudes, how long have you been doing this? So, Nudes, this is a throwback to May of 2020. Was that before I was streaming? That was before I was streaming. May of 2020. So, Nudes has been doing these, like, big-ass meal things for a while. What is this? What is this one? Let's enhance. Okay. Spicy red sauce. I have no idea. Nudes is gonna have to, is it like a curry? I think I see some carrots. There's two different, so there's something back here that's different than these ones right here. Interesting. Pre-peeled garlic, yeah. Today I bought tiny mozzarella balls in olive oil and herbs. Ooh, I've seen this pack before. I hope they are tasty. I haven't bought them before, but I know what you're talking about because we have something similar here. They're like this big, little mozzarella balls. And yeah, they're in like a little vacuum sealed pack thing, or maybe it was a thing with a lid. But yeah, and they're soaking in olive oil and herbs. Yeah, I haven't gotten it yet, but I really should get that for Malin because he likes the flavor of caprese salads with like tomato, mozzarella, and basil. I think he would absolutely love that. This is during IED. It's sambal cuttlefish. Oh my God, I love cuttlefish. It's super delicious. Lol. No carrots were involved. Okay, so it's just cuttlefish. Cuttlefish. It's hard to get cuttlefish here. Yeah, I mean, you can get it from the Korean market, but your selection's pretty limited. It's always frozen. But cuttlefish is pretty tasty. Ooh, also, let's go. This is what I'm talking about. Nudes also throwing up the late night craving for puchujan, garlic chive pancakes. Yeah. Puchu is Asian chives, and jeon is cake. So when people are like, oh, you can also call it puchupajeon, which is because I tend to go overly formal with my Korean sometimes. Puchupajeon is how I would say it, but the abbreviated version is puchujan. I think that's actually the right way to say it too, is puchujan, which is chives. Savory pancakes. And then what's in the corner here looks like a dipping sauce with my guess, if I were making it, it would be soy sauce, a little bit of rice wine vinegar, sesame oil, chili flakes, and then the diced up onions is what I would do. There's some other extra more coarse chili flakes in there besides like gochugaru. There's something else in there too, but that is the kind of spicy fun dipping sauce for it. Yummy, yummy, in the tummy. Jason David Frank. Ah, that's his name, the Green Ranger. Original Green / White Ranger. Also does virtual training. I dropped a link in random. Oh my gosh. Wow. I have not seen him, the actor, since, God, 20 years. I don't know what he looks like now, but if he aged well, he probably looks pretty good. And I imagine he aged well. He's like still fit and doing martial arts. Ooh, virtual, cool. Yeah, I kind of want to take a class. Maybe this is what I'll do on my Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday while my kids are at daycare or at preschool. I'll just like check out the Green Ranger and do his fitness classes in the comfort of my home. I'll actually be oogling him, but my husband will be like, what are you doing? I'll be like, I'm working out with the Green Ranger. It'll be great. Eid Fitri is a celebration after Ramadan, and since we can't celebrate with friends and family, we sent out food to them. Oh, Nudes, that's so sweet of you. That's awesome. Way to go. Way to support your community. Speaking of Nudes, also thrown down, comfort Sunday foods. It's Kuay Tiao noodle soup, rice noodle soup. Ooh, it looks a little spicy, too. So I'm guessing that's Napa cabbage? correct me if I'm wrong. Napa cabbage, very wide noodles, chilies, bird's eye chilies, Thai chilies, probably Thai chilies. Very nice. It's funny because the soup broth looks very light and refreshing, and then boom, bunch of chilies on top. Like, just when you thought this was a nice, easy, comfort meal, boom, burn your mouth off. I love it. Mama Silva says he's still handsome. Uh-oh. That's what's keeping him in business. Like, he's still fit, he's doing martial arts, he's doing training, and he's pretty to look at. You do know, like, the personal trainers and the fitness instructors, the good-looking ones, man, they make so much more bank and get so many more clients. I don't know why. I don't know why that is. Why do looks matter so much, specifically in, like, fitness training? I don't know why, but it's true. It's totally true. He was in recent Power Rangers. He's still worth looking at. The chilies are just pickled chilies, a mix of both normal and Thai. Ooh, thank you. Good to know. His classes are only $30. What the fuck are you talking about? You're not serious. $30 a month? I was almost about to pay $200 a month for fucking Orange Theory. Discord? Random? AFK, random. Oh, I see the moose. That is a small moose. Train Me JDF Rising Sun Karate Academy. Jason David Frank. Just show me a picture of him. Where's his face? Enroll now. Enter website. Oh, was that him? Let's scroll. Oh, he did age. He did age pretty well. Not bad at all. Okay. I'm gonna leave it on my phone so later on when I open it up I can like really ponder seriously if I'm gonna pay $30 a month to look at the Green Ranger and take his karate classes. Might just have to do that. Oh my god, Mal's gonna come up. Oh, that's actually not a bad idea. Okay. For anyone who knows, our den is right there next to the kitchen. And I have Lena's sensory swing hanging from the den. And it's got like an eye hook thing. And then, welcome in, T. Gomez.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached. Head is matted black. Got the boots black and matte.
Welcome in, T. Gomez. How are you? How is your day going? Thank you so much for the raid. Welcome in. We're talking about whether or not I should sign up to take the Green Ranger from Power Rangers fitness class he has online. He's teaching karate. And we're also looking at food porn together. And whoever said it was Mary Todd. Yes. Also, they have to have a good personality too. That is 100% true. Some of them are a little bit more like some have the tough love thing going. Some of them are like the really cheerleader booster type, but having a personal trainer or a martial arts instructor or any sort of fitness person, personality does matter a lot too. That has been my problem. I've had 3 personal trainers in my life. I'll go to a gym. They'll always give you like a free personal trainer. And then you like do a couple sessions with them for free. And then if you like them, you can sign up or keep going or something like that. I've never had a good personal trainer. Never. No. 2 of them were dudes. Both of them creeped me out. And then I had one that was a girl, but she was way younger than me. And it was just weird and awkward. Because the age difference made it very strange for us. Because we had, like, nothing to talk about. And it was weird. Like, yeah, it was a really odd balance. So I've never had a good personal trainer. I had a lot of really, really good martial arts instructors, though. We did not update any of the commands. No, sorry, we're just doing a field trip today, and I made that yesterday, or part of that for yesterday. Gotta have a good personality. Yep, it was a long, how was the Denver Zoo? It was a long day at the zoo, but fun overall that we are going back on Monday. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Cheers, salute to you. Did you guys make it through the whole zoo, or were you smart and not plow through the whole zoo? I am learning to do what T. Gomez just said. If you're going to the zoo, especially with little kids, Like, except that you need to break it up into a multiple day thing. We tried to do the whole zoo in one day. It was a terrible idea. We accomplished it, but man, Jace was like melting down and I had to carry him out and he fell asleep in my arms and he's dead weight when he's asleep because he's really heavy. Really, what we should have done was we should have split the zoo into 2 days and we should have gone a lot slower. It would have been a lot better. You would still drool over original Black Ranger. He aged like fine. Oh, hex. Yeah, I do know he looks good. I checked up on him not too long ago. He did. Bill, was it Billy? Was Billy the Black Ranger or the Blue Ranger? I can't remember, but you're right. He did age well, that's right. Actually, Amy Jo Johnson, who played Kimberly, she also aged really well too, I believe. I didn't check up on Trini though. I don't know how well she aged, but I'm imagining well. I love Power Rangers! Yeah, we're talking about Power Rangers too. And Scooby-Doo. Billy was the Blue Ranger, thank you. Made it through 80% of the zoo since most are in remodeling. Some animals aren't out for guests to see. Ah, okay, that makes sense. Makes sense. All right, next up we're gonna look at Alice. I really need to take my daughter to the zoo. She loves animals. She does. She doesn't like touching them. She likes them to stay far away, but she likes to look at animals and she loves to walk around. And I think because it's outdoors and there's no like lights and buildings, I think she'd be okay. My daughter cannot go into a building. If I take her into any building besides this house and the school that we picked Jace up from, she screams. She just screams bloody murder. She hates new places. But I think the zoo, being that it's mostly outdoor, I think she'd actually really like it. We should try taking her there. But we also have to acknowledge if we take her somewhere, especially even though we pay like $30 to get into the zoo, we have to acknowledge there's a high probability that 15 minutes later we're gonna have to walk right back out. I wonder if they have a refund policy. I should call to see if they have a refund policy. If you bring a kid into the zoo and they just fucking melt down, if you're allowed to like get your money back on the way out. Or like, can we walk in, like dip our toe in the water to see if she'll take it? And then if she does, we'll pay to spend the day there. But if she just melts down, like, I don't know how that works. I might have to call ahead, but I never know what's gonna set her off. I just know in general, Lena cannot handle any new environment. She just freaks out. Unless it's outside or in the wilderness. She fucking loves the wilderness. So, Alyssa made steak and Alfredo pizza. Ooh, that gives me an idea. I'm thinking about doing pizzas on Fridays. Like, every week, we can tweak the dough a bit, but every week, we just make a new pizza on Fridays. So, I can get the dough started in the beginning of the day, we can make a pizza, and then we can do our trivia while the pizza's baking or something like that. But I think I might want to start doing pizza Fridays, pizza party Fridays. Steak and Alfredo sounds amazing. And then, I don't know, maybe I'll learn not to burn pizzas after a while. That looks beautiful. Shall we zoom? I think we should. But, oh, I didn't zoom very far on that one. Ooh, oh, look at that nice color. So good. Oh, nicely done. Nicely done, Alice. Trini sadly isn't with us in it. Oh my god, I think I did know that. Maybe that's why I didn't see what she aged like. The actress who played Trini passed away years ago. That's why. Okay, thank you. I'm stupid. I forgot that. I was wondering why I didn't see, I don't remember an updated picture of her. I did, like, when the new Power Rangers movie came out, I remember looking up all the old actors to like see where are they now. And I remember Trini passed away, and that's why the only image I have of her in my head is from when she was a lot younger. Yeah, I heard Power Rangers was actually cursed. Like, a lot of people died making Power Rangers. Surprisingly, it's weird. Denver Zoo even opened charity for collections for all the zoos in the Ukraine. We donated $100. Oh, Tico West, that's awesome. Good on you. What's up, Frozen? How are you? Pizza! Welcome in. We're doing pretty good. We're doing pretty good. Had a great conversation with one of my best friends. She was here for supper club. It was just the two of us, which is one of the reasons why I'm late on Thursdays is because I usually have friends over. But people are either out of town or working or whatever. So it was just me and Jenny. And we had a really long, nice conversation. It was really good. I think it's a good pep talk that I needed. I had a lot of fun. And now we're doing food porn and having a cocktail. and talking about martial arts, Power Rangers, Scooby-Doo, and the proper ratio of ingredients when brining a chicken. The zoo was limited on capacity. I would call them to talk to a supervisor. Yeah, I always feel like they call them Karens. I feel bad because there's probably really nice Karens out there in the world. But I feel like one of those crazy moms when I do that. But honestly, to take both my kids to the zoo plus myself and most likely another adult, because I very rarely take both my kids out in public by myself. We usually need man-on-man coverage when we take our kids out. So usually I'll like bribe a friend or my brother or someone to come with me, or Sabrina when she's in town. Maybe when Sabrina comes to town, we'll take the kids to the zoo. But it's expensive to go to the zoo. I don't know how much it costs for you, but for an adult, it's like $20, and a kid, it's like $15. Even if they're like little kids, it still costs like $15 to take them to the zoo. So at that point, you're spending, $60 or something like that to take everyone to the zoo, plus, you know, lunch and the gift shop and everything else. So it would suck to like go to the zoo, spend all this money, and then 15 minutes later have to walk right back out. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the zoo's not used to doing refunds, so it'd be a whole drama to get your money refunded. And it's not the zoo's fault that my kid is not comfortable in situations. So yeah, I have no idea how that works. But yeah, I'll call ahead. Or I don't know. I'm pretty sure if I just walk up to the place and ask them, maybe. Last time we were there, we were waiting for my brother and my sister-in-law to get there at the zoo. And they were running late and we got there early and Jace had to go potty. And so I went up there. I was like, dude, I'm waiting for my sibling to get here, but my son really has to go to the bathroom. And they're like, oh yeah, just walk right in and go to the bathroom. And they were like the most laid back, chill people ever. They're like, yeah, go ahead. Come back whenever you're ready. And I was like, wow, I could totally be, what kind of mom is going to sneak into the zoo with a 5-year-old though? It was like first thing in the morning, they just opened, but hopefully they're laid back. You kind of have Kathy. What did I do? In Japan, Power Rangers is called Super Sentai. Ooh, I like it. It's okay when you call ahead and ask. Fair enough. Psst, Kathy, 30 minutes left till midnight. Thank you, nudes. Yes, let's hurry up. We do need to get to bed at a decent time. I have to go pick up the kids tomorrow. Lena also was not feeling super well tonight when she went to bed. She was fine the whole day, and then for some reason she cried hysterically at night. So I actually had to hold her and comfort her until she fell asleep, which was kind of awesome because she usually never lets me hold her. Another angle for Alice's pizza. This is actually pretty cool. Look at the, I wonder what kind of dough she used for the crust. Give me my mouse. Look at the crust. You can see like the nice airy holes. Yeah, that looks like a nice soft pillowy crust. Very cool. All right, next up is Nudes. Woo, what's this spread? Nudes throwing down with, oh my God, this is the thing she was talking about. It is an Oreo Spam cheeseburger. Habanero infused buns, all right. Habanero infused buns, heard. Maple glazed Spam. Maple glazed Spam, basically like bacon at that point, right? Oreo cheese habanero sauce. Okay, I'm open to it. I would put it in my mouth. Pickled red onions. Beef patties, om nom 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 beef patties. And Oreo crumbs, which are off somewhere else. This is Nudes' Oreo Spam cheeseburger. It's about the same cost depending on the time of the year, but we have membership and our EBT card. With EBT card, you can get in for $1 per person for up to 10 people. What? Yeah, we don't have that. Here in Denver, many places offer that EBT card deal too. Also, some places have free days too. I don't know about free days. I do know our zoo has a special... They used to, before the pandemic, they had a special window of time that was specifically designated for kids with sensory processing issues. And I don't know if it was like early or whatever, but they like dimmed the lights and it was like a lot more, it was specifically made for kids with any sort of sensory processing challenges. mostly kids with autism, and they have special hours and stuff like that. So if I go during the special hours, which I don't think they're doing them right now during the pandemic, but before the pandemic, I know that they had special hours that my kids could have gone. I don't know. I can't call ahead and see what's up. Woo! Nudes! Double stack! No, it's not a double stack. That's a single stack. Okay, so we got buns. Boom! Bun. Oreo crumbles. Pickled red onions. Spam layer. I can see some of the sauce and cheese. More red onions. This is it's a double stack. There are two patties. Wow. How was it? I want to know how it was. When you get done with food pics, I posted a pet picture. Oh my gosh. Okay, it looks like we're going all over on the field trip tonight. Sounds good. Thank you for that, Frozen. I don't understand what this means. Okay, I think this is a ban. Yeah. We'll just delete that message and ban them. Because I'm pretty sure that's not the way you introduce yourself to chat. Okay. Manners, people. Oh my God, that looks so good. Frozen is excited about the Oreo Spam Cheeseburger. It is a double patty. It is a double. Why Oreo? I don't know, because that's what she chose. What? That is also what Armageddon was also wondering. It was a challenge. A selfie in random too. Yeah, I saw the selfie. I did see the selfie, Frozen. Very cute. Oh, here's another picture. Ooh, man, your fries look huge in this picture. Very cool. Look at that double stack Spam Oreo cheeseburger with crispy fries. I want to know what it tasted like. Was it delicious? Was it amazing? It was a challenge. Also, because of Eaterin. Oh, right. This was inspired by Eaterin. Ooh, I love what, this is a funny picture. I love what New Vision says. I just read it. It ain't mold, lol. Okay, so for anyone who's wondering, like, why is this bun an interesting color? You can see right here the interesting colors. New Vision explains. Let's scroll this down for a hot second. Center. Okay. Oh, what interesting color burger you have there. Okay, here we go. My take on an Oreo. What is this Oreo Spam burger that Eaterin has started with everyone that I missed? Okay, my take on an Oreo Spam cheeseburger crafted by a fancy food expert, Nudes, a challenge to make a crazy idea tasty. That is quite a challenge. Here's my take. Here's my take when I used blue Oreos. Oreo crumb infused buns, Oreo cream miso mayo, Oreo cream glazed Spam with provolone topped with a double Oklahoma smash burger. It ain't mold. That's blue Oreos. Ah, okay, got it. What bread is that, Frozen? It is blue Oreo infused bread. That's what it is. Frozen posts another one. From his more cursed Oreo cheeseburger. Ah. I didn't hate it, Nudes. That's a strong positive comment. Didn't hate it. I actually have a clip eating at that burger somewhere on this side of the Twitchverse. Oh, I want to see this. Oh yeah, Vision asked me to make an edible version. That is interesting, I believe. Dropped you a surprise in random. Sounds good. Thank you so much. Oh, there's more pictures. Okay, here's another one of New Vision's. Oh, lordy. I'm trying to think if I did an Oreo Spam. So, Spam cheeseburger, not hard at all. I would probably cheat and, like, I think I would, like, brine something or marinate something using like the Oreo cream. I think I would do what New Vision did as well. I would probably crumble the Oreo. I would crumble the Oreo cookie up and somehow mix that into the buns, I'm guessing. Or knowing me, I would actually smash up the Oreo cookie with some milk and make like a paste and then mix that into the burger patty as like a binding agent. Yeah. It's a very rich burger, says. Yeah, it sounds like a lot. I'm trying to figure out how you would take so many intense flavors and mellow it out. That would be really hard. I'd probably put the Oreo cookie in the burger itself as like a binding agent. I like the idea of using the inside of the Oreo, the creamy part, and doing something, yeah, like using that as like sugar in a sauce. So like if you made like a citrus aioli or something and wanted to add a little bit of sweetness to it, something like that. Yeah, it's a tough one. Or you could use an unsweetened ketchup and use the Oreo, because I have no or sugar-free ketchup. You could use the Oreo sweetener in that.
I feel like it can't decide if it wants to be a dessert or umami.
Yeah, yeah. It's kind of tricky. I would definitely disguise the Oreo so you wouldn't actually know there's Oreo in it. Whereas I give props to Nudes and New Vision where they kind of like highlighted the Oreo. Like it was, you could definitely tell there's Oreo in it. I would be sneaky. I'd be like an Oreo ninja and I would hide the cookie in the burger. And then I would put the cream filling of the Oreo cookie and I would mix it with some sort of condiment. Oh my God, Nudes, let's go. Dun, 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 dun. Does this work? Oh, it does work.
This and this.
Mmm. How is it?
It's nice.
It is nice.
Nice. And I'm not joking you. It is nice.
It is nice. Yay! Thank you for that, Nudes. Honestly, needed pickles and raw onions, the yellow onions. Okay. So, yeah, I think all that sweetness, it needs something tangy or whatnot to balance it out. Yeah. Get all the flavors up in there. Updates, no burger was wasted. Oh, I love it. Oh, what's this? Nudes. What is this? Tried the rice paper hack for tteokbokki, mixed both of them together and tested out. It really tasted similar. It's a great hack. Also, might have used 3 Thai chilies and made 1/3 of Mongchi's recipe. This was fire! Oh, wow. So wait, what is the... So the rice paper hack for tteokbokki is, I think, you roll the rice paper up to the point that it makes like a rice cake? Is that what the hack is? Very rich. Thank you, Margets, for the bits. Need pickles. Blah. I hate ketchup. Fair enough. Fair enough. In America, we eat ketchup on a lot of things. Or maybe a barbecue sauce. Yeah? Because barbecue sauces tend to be sweet. So maybe sub out the brown sugar in a barbecue sauce with the Oreo cream filling and then add some molasses. Yeah, basically brown sugar at that point. Right? You can make a barbecue sauce that way. I would definitely be more of a pansy. I would do my best to disguise the Oreo and like mix it in and you would never know there's Oreo in it. But yeah, that's hard to do. I use ketchup to cook with, not as a dip. Ah, yeah, some Korean moms will use ketchup in tteokbokki like this. When it's too spicy, they'll add the ketchup instead of gochujang. I had to mute for hear. Oh, I had to mute from hearing my own voice. It's okay, Nudes. I do the same thing. I hate watching clips of myself, and I never watch my VODs because it just makes me uncomfortable. Nudes, this looks delicious. Very, very tasty. You know what? I'm going to make some tteokbokki soon. I can't remember the last time I had tteokbokki. I love tteokbokki. I'm going to make a lot of I haven't been able to eat a lot of Korean food for like the past year. I'm going to eat a lot of Korean food coming up. Shadow did a meat mountain. I almost read that as Mountain Dew. Meat mountain on a bed of rice. Had some leftover beef that was about 3 days away from going bad, so I quickly sauteed it with some green onions, garlic, and bell peppers. It's a wonderful stir-fry dish. Yeah, meat mountain on a bed of rice. Well done, Shadow. Awesome, awesome. Quick and easy stir-fry. I love it. Barbecue sauce, I also don't like that. Nudes, you don't like barbecue sauce either? Howdy, Mrs. Kitchen. Howdy, Shadow. Nice timing. We were just looking at your meat mountain. Yeah, it looks delicious. Frozen says, I hate American ketchup. In Italy and Spain, it is so much more flavorful. Wow, maybe we should Google that. How to make Italian and Spanish ketchup. fun. Arma gets his take on the Oreo Spam Cheeseburger Challenge. At most, I'd fry the Spam, bread it in the Oreo, throw it in a high-end balsamic vinegar on top, add whipped cream so the cheese and other condiments toast the bread. You forgot the beef patty! Alright, but that still sounds cool. No other cheese or condiments. Smart. Okay, that made my mouth water. Ha, right? What's up, Minnie? Welcome in. How are you? Nice to see you. We're looking at food porn. Ooh, more comfort food. Looking good. Nude starting now with comfort, comfy curry with some bread to soak it all up. Is that chicken? That looks like some tasty chicken. All right. That looks like a chicken wing. Potatoes, carrots, more chicken, deliciousness, and some bread. Soak it all up. Yeah, that looks great. Nice and comforting. I'm all down for the comfort foods, especially lately. Oh, look, here's all the ingredients that made it. Okie dokie. What do we have here? Okay, so this is like the base of the curry. We got some chicken wings. Called it on the chicken wing. Chicken wings. We got some coconut cream. Carrots and potatoes. And then I'm guessing this is the chicken stock. Homemade chicken stock. Nice. Very good. This says balsamic vinegar is not something easily can buy. Oh, that sucks. In Europe, they don't use chemical preservatives like they use here. Yeah, America kind of sucks in that regard. For shizzle. We put chemicals in fucking everything. Some of them contain... Oh, and some of them contain alcohol. So Nudes has to be very careful on the stuff she chooses. Everything has to be halal. So yeah, definitely got to be careful about that. Again, beef patty is super amazing. I don't know if I'd like it with the Oreo. Now I'm like kind of half curious about trying it. Now I'm intrigued enough that I almost want to try this too. Alice is throwing down with beef purses and fried rice balls. Ooh, fun. Both recipes from 17th century England with a modern twist. What? I have never made a 17th century recipe, but I like the historical. That's a really fun idea. It's like doing historical food. I've done some medieval cuisine before because I used to do, I was hanging out with some people who did SCA medieval cooking things where they reenacted or they found really old recipes from like the medieval ages and they translated them and then tried to make them in modern times. That sounds super fun. Where does one find a 17th century England recipe? Beef purses are these tingies right here. Very cool. And here are the fried rice balls. That is so fun. That's really freaking fun. I'm very inspired by the idea of medieval cooking or historical cooking. Have you ever tried to make anything with bison, Nudes? Ooh, bison could be fun. As long as it's halal for Nudes. Yeah, bison's pretty fun. I've done a bison steak and a bison burger, but my bison experience has been very limited. I don't know about Nudes, though. What's everyone's preferred sub shop? We have a place called Tubbs Gourmet Subs that's pretty good. Malin likes Jersey Mike's. And there's another one. I don't like Subway very much. Jersey Mike's is good. What's the other one besides Jersey Mike's? It's like their top competitor. Jimmy John's! Jimmy John's is not so bad either. I do. Jimmy John's might be local. I don't know if you guys have Jimmy John's. I know you guys don't have Tubbs. Tubbs Gourmet Subs is a Seattle thing. Jimmy John's is pretty good. Madeline likes Jimmy John's a lot. And Jersey Mike's is pretty good. I don't have a favorite, though. Whichever one's closer. I will say, we tend to get... When we're on the road and we're doing, like, road trips and stuff, we tend to do Jimmy John's a lot. So here are the beef purses all zoomed in. Ooh, they look so good. Are those fried or baked? They look baked, right? Yeah, they look baked because they look like they have an egg wash on them. Very nice. Very nice. Those are the beef purses, and these are the fried rice balls. I wonder if there's anything inside the rice balls or if they're just, like... balls of rice that have been fried. Either way, sounds good. I don't think we have bison here. Bison's hard to get even here in the States. Like, you have to go to a specialty place to get it. Bison and elk are amazing. Teague Gomez, yes. I believe they're... I haven't had elk in a really long time. I heard that moose is the best. Absolutely the best. Rosa says, oh my God, have you seen the TikToks that makes old recipes, like from the Depression era stuff? He looks like a small Captain America. He's adorbs. I have not. I don't watch TikTok. My husband watches TikTok, but I have not seen TikTok. But I like Depression era cooking. I saw this guy who had a YouTube channel where I think he was the camera guy. And his grandmother, who lived through the Great Depression, was the one who was on camera. And she was showing all the recipes and teaching him how to make all the food that she would cook, I think, for his mom? Or when she was little? Yeah. Anyways, I thought that was a really cool show. I can't remember what it was called, but I really like the Great Depression YouTube channel with the granny who taught. I watched the one where she made dandelion salad.
Shadow. So I have a fancy printer that's about 1.5 feet tall, specifically made to print an image on the Guinness beer foam using food coloring made for that specific beer foam. So you download and send an image to the machine at Tardar.
Wait, hold up. So they have a I was asking earlier, like, how the fuck did you do this? My mind was blown at the Mortal Kombat Guinness. Okay. So they have a fancy printer that's 1.5 feet tall, specifically made. So it's taller than the pint glass, specifically made to print an image on Guinness beer foam using food coloring made for that specific beer foam. So you have the printer, I guess you put the pint glass under the printer and then it prints on the foam using edible print. So you download an image, sent to the machine, and ta-da. Oh my God, I was blown away with that, Shadow. That is like the coolest shit I've ever heard. That's absolutely amazing. Super cool. Almost makes me want to buy one. Nudes is not from the States. That is correct. I can order online. She probably can't. Moose Tooth, local to Wasilla. What's Moose Tooth? No tubs. I used to be a shift manager for Jersey Mike's and Jersey Mike's subs. I was a shift manager for Subway and disliked Firehouse subs. I've never had Firehouse subs though. I like the name. I'm Native American, German, Irish, and Italian. I've been told my cooking would make Guy Fieri say shut the redacted up instead of shut the front door. Oh my God, Mama Silva, I love it. I love it. You should throw some of your pictures here in the food pick section. Frozen says, I got elk this year. 6 point, it's in the fridge now. I'm nom 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 nom. Yeah, I haven't cooked. I would love an elk stew. I think that would be really good. Or like an elk steak would be good too, but I think I would really enjoy elk. I like game meats and stews. That's one of my favorite ways. Shadow throwing down with bits.
Actually, that thing was more like 2.5 feet. But yeah, you put it on the machine, and when it's ready to print, it lifts it all the way up to the top where part of the glass disappears and you hear it printing. I got two other images, so I'll go ahead and post them.
Awesome! Thank you so much. That sounds super cool. I've never heard of this. Good God, if we had this here in Seattle. Well, one, maybe we already do, and I'm not cool and I don't know about it. But, dude, if they had this at one of my local pubs, I would be all over this. Okay, so Shadow throwing down with gold mine of sweet corn on top of canned corned beef cooked with bell peppers and sesame oil over rice. Oh my gosh, okay, one more time. Gold mine of sweet corn on top of canned corned beef cooked with bell peppers and sesame oil over rice. Very nice. It's like a good fusion food. Ooh, here's a cross-section. We do love all the different angles and all the cross-sections. There it is! This kind of reminds me, this kind of reminds me of like a shepherd's pie. Just like the layers, like carbs, meatiness, fruit, or vegetables. It kind of, like an Asian interpretation of a shepherd's pie is what this brings to mind. Like a reverse shepherd's pie. Very nice, hearty food. Very comforting. Looks good, Shadow. Nicely done. Sub sandwiches, says Mary Todd's. Love Jersey Mike's and local place to me called Robert's Italian Deli. Nice, Mitty. Also, like what Kathy said, everything I buy to cook with has to be halal certified. Yeah, so it limits what Nudes can use for her ingredients. But yeah, if they had one that wasn't ridiculously expensive, because Nudes tried to get halal turkey for Thanksgiving, and it was like $80 for a turkey or something ridiculous. So yeah, hopefully she'll be able to get it sometimes. Why do you hate Firehouse? I don't know, Frozen. Why do you hate it, Tegel Miss? Thank you, Shadow, for the bits. I remember this. Yeah, Mama Silva is a head chef at a diner. I remember you telling us about this. I think we were talking about this around Thanksgiving. Yeah, wasn't your diner doing something around Thanksgiving that was pretty awesome? T. Gomez says, elk sends them my way. Lol, and their stuff makes me sick. I work for Jersey Mike's subs, though. I miss working for Jersey Mike's subs, though. So the Firehouse makes her sick. Ooh, Shadow. Liz Nami, what's up?
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached. Head is matted black. Got the boosters black to match.
Liz Nami, thank you so much for the raid. Okay, I didn't actually mean to blow it that loudly because my babies are asleep, but that was a pretty nice raid horn. That was like one of my best raid horns I've done in a while. Welcome in, Raiders, to the AFK Kitchen. Blizz Nami, how was your stream? What did you get on with today? Welcome, guys, to the AFK Kitchen. My name is Kathy. I stream pretty much every single day. Eventually, I will take a break someday. I'm on 400 and fuck, how many streams? Am I at 440 streams? I'm 440 streams in a row. Welcome, it's a charity stream. It is a mature stream, so if you're under 18, please don't let me know or I'll have to ban you. But it's a charity stream. We raise money for St. Jude's Children's Hospital. That is our current campaign. All donations will go directly to St. Jude's. We do not accept personal donations. And then all bits and subs go to feed our local homeless shelter, which we do every Thursday. We did that today. And we donated ribs, roasted broccoli, chicken fried rice, and I also threw in a chicken casserole as well. But welcome in. Welcome to the AFK Kitchen. Glad you guys are here. We drink too much, we swear too much, and I often burn food, but we try to make the world a better place in our own kind of fucked up way, so we're glad you guys are here to share this with us. Welcome in. Raiding my kitchen IRL, so raiding a kitchen on Twitch! I love it, Blizz Nami. Absolutely love it. Just chatting and Wordle today, ending with Halo. Oh my god, I can't play FPS games if my life depended on it. I've tried. I've taken tutoring lessons on things like Halo or... Not even did Counter-Strike. But yeah, first-person shooters are not my jam. So props to you, Blizz Nami. Also, I like your name. It makes me think of Blizzard, the game studio, and Nami, like the Japanese word for wave. That's what your name makes me think of. I love it. It's Thursday today. Shit. I know it's Thursday, right? Fuck. Thank you for the raid. Armageddon is saying that we're also talking about food and looking at food porn. Walt's drinking mason jars full of alcohol, which is not full anymore. It's actually almost empty. That's very disappointing. This was a rum and coke. It's gone. But welcome in. Armageddon's throwing down like Armageddon does. Elk is overrated. We're talking about elk and game meats. In my opinion, it's too lean and gamey. I've spent all day trying to process the elk, the flavor of elk. Armageddon, again. Fucking stew, right? If you're gonna, maybe not a steak, again, don't you think? Like, I feel like this is the same with so many other gamey flavored meats. Put in a stew. Sounds good. Frozen says, it is the healthiest meat you can eat on land. That's the point. I don't want healthy, I want tasty. Beckerman Logic, welcome in. Hi, welcome into the AFK Kitchen. Glad you're here. Moose is the best, says Mary Todd.
Eventually I'll skip a day, I don't think so. You'll definitely come close. But then you'll consider how much effort went into the current streak.
Okay, you make good points, Armageddon. You do make good points. However, I will take a break after my 500th stream. So my 500th stream is on a Sunday. I think... Oh shit, we woke the toddler. Hey, okay. Yes, you are. He's wide awake too. All right, we're about to get raided. In person. Are you dressed?
Hello, we're dressed.
dude. Exclamation point, Jace. What? Anything else? Daddy's in the room. Why don't you go see Daddy? He's in Mommy's room. I'll get you some milk. Arbogets!
Yeah, that's the only way I've been able to serve elk and moose. In some sort of stew. Often after marinating in seasoned buttermilk.
Yeah. The buttermilk takes out some of the gamey flavor, right?
Interwebs will mess with Kathy or electricity.
Someday something will happen. Someday I will miss the stream. I've gotten pretty close a couple times. But I think I will take a day off after my 500th stream. I feel like I have to eventually do it. I'm gonna miss a day someday. The fact that I went 365 days straight, it's still shocking to me. Because I was expecting, having four kids, I was expecting one of them to break my streak in one way or another. The fact that they didn't is amazing. One sec, let me give this to a toddler. Here you go. Go see Daddy. He's in Mommy's room. I love you. You can go into Maya's room, but you cannot come in the kitchen. Okay? You should just go right here and go down. Be careful. All right. Trying not to get kicked off Twitch. All right. Catching up on chat. Chatting Wordle today, ending with Halo. Sounds good. Firehouse subs are the meh. The food is okay-ish, but the idea that they are donating money to firefighters is pretty cool. That's why I liked it, Shelberto. Please put it on Discord. Thank you. Yeah?
But Kathy, look at the professional setup you have now for drunken chat streams, lol.
It's pretty true. That's one of the reasons why I can't ever quit streaming is because we redid the whole kitchen. What's up? What'd you say, Jace? Where are you coming from? I can't hear you. Oh, what's up? What are you doing here? Go into Maya's room. Oh my gosh. Sorry, my kid does not understand how this house works. Come here, baby. This way. Come here. Just go right here. They can't see you from here, Jace. Just go. They can't see you. There you go. Perfect. Thank you for being careful and thank you for asking. He was trying to go that way, but he was scared you guys would see him, so he went all the way around trying to hide from the camera. He's not presentable for the camera right now. Don't mind my toddler. Kiwi Wolf, welcome in. Hi, nice to see you. Retro says, I gotta stop going to the emergency room, just saying. I was there March 1st and again today, Friday morning. Oh my God, Retro, I'm so sorry. Why do you keep going to the emergency room? Blizzard Army says, oi, what's the food you made? Chives, rice, beef, the pick. Oh, that is, we're on a field trip. It is pictures from our food pick section in our Discord. This is all of chat. So this is Shadow, Dancing Shadow's food. She made rice and, oh wait, this is a different one. Oh my God, I'm sorry. I haven't read this one yet. Okay. A delicious ice cold Dos Equis from the deepest part of Mexico, accented with some even colder vodka that would the mightiest of drinkers turn red. So she made a El Dictator, which is Dos Equis with vodka. Oh, and there's some bowl with green onion, sesame oil, beef bulgogi, surrounding rice. Okay, so the dish is a bulgogi bowl. She, like, half that paragraph was her describing the drink, and then, oh yeah, there's like some bulgogi bowl up there too. And that is what's going on. That is the time. Thank you, Armigas, for the bits. I'm sorry, I'm behind on chat. We got bombed by Jace. That's our 5-year-old. He often bombs stream around 10 p.m. Oh, well, he's 2 hours late. We appreciate your patience while he demands milk, snacks, and cartoons. That is exactly what he did. I forgot the command. It's all good. Oh, shit, I forgot his name. My bad. It's okay. Connor is one of our friends on Twitch. Interrupts with Miss Kathy. Yeah, that's totally going to happen, too. Thank you for that. T. Gomez is going to bed. Nighty night, T. Gomez. Thanks for hanging out. Have a wonderful rest of your night and good luck at the zoo on Monday. elk steak is the main way I eat it. Then stew is okay. 99, see y'all's later. T Gomez, 99, thank you so much for being here. And elk steak, let's go. I'm down for some elk filet mignon. Wrap that shit up in some bacon. All right, next up on our field trip is from Alice. Alice threw down with, tonight I made ground beef wellies. Is this like a ground beef Wellington? What's a wellies? The younger, less sophisticated cousin of beef Wellington. Okay, there you go. Less effort to cook, still very delicious. This is like English bao. If you've ever made like hum bao or Chinese bao, like baked bao, a welly, if I'm not mistaken, sounds a lot like a bao. You could, a Wellington bao. What if you did everything that was in a beef Wellington, the duck cell and all that stuff, but you did it in a bao bun? My mouth just filled with saliva. And you made baked bao, like Chinese style bao, the buns, but it was all beef Wellington. This is one of the best ideas I've ever had. I gotta write this down. I will make this next week. Okay, we're gonna make some Wellington baos. Wellington bao. Exclamation point, underline three times. Genius! I fucking love fusion food. All right, T Gomez, thank you for being here. Have a good night. Need to get to sleep, but didn't know it was 12 a.m. Oh, Frozen, we're right behind you. Thank you, Armageddon, for the bits. You're right, we have a very elaborate stream in our kitchen. I have to keep streaming because I have this, my whole kitchen has been converted for Twitch streams. Doesn't mean I have to stream every day, though. Shelbert says, the wedding you have to be in will for sure break the stream. Well, we'll see. We did go camping. So when we go out and about, my streams tend to be shorter, and then they're like IRL streams or just chatting streams. We've lost power multiple times, and what we ended up doing was putting a fire in the fireplace, and then I did calligraphy streams. And every time someone came in to chat, I would write their name in calligraphy because I was practicing my calligraphy. They got to pick the color, and then sometimes they got to pick the word, and I would write whatever fucking word they came up with in calligraphy, and we just chatted and drank wine by the fireplace. So we get creative on streams. I don't do cooking streams every single day. I just do them most days. But we get creative when we are in desperate times. Yeah. I won't lie. I want you to grow and do your dreams, but I'm low-key sad about the impact your desired career will have on streams. Yep, I'm addicted. It's okay, Armageddon. You guys know I'm addicted to you too. It's, yeah, we'll have a break here or there. Things will happen. But I do think the going back to school, I'm going to be able to do that during the classes, the studies, the homework. I think I'm going to be able to do that during the day while the kids are at school. So hopefully we'll still keep streams going. Mrs. Kitchen is Fridays now. Cheers. Cheers. Shadow. Cheers. You're right. Rachel said, I had not heard about the new career. It's like 2 years out, but I am going back to school for landscape design. My goal in the future is to help people build thriving, beautiful ecosystem gardens in their backyard. So what I'm doing is I'm doing it in my yard first, and it's going to be like my showroom. So we're dropping a pretty penny on re-landscaping and redesigning and redoing our whole outside living area. And then when the neighbors or anyone else are like, oh, you have a big ass pond and waterfall in your background, I'm like, yes, I designed it myself. So, and then I'm taking classes and doing all that stuff. So I want to get into landscape design. So I want to make people have pretty gardens in their yard. But it's like a couple years out. I got to take some classes and I got to get some other stuff under my belt and then we'll do it. I'm in no rush. It's not, if it works, it works. If it doesn't, I'll just continue to be a stay-at-home mom, but it's kind of like a project I want to do on the side. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, that is my plan. She's going to school to get licensed for landscape designing in fall. Oh, Armageddon gets worded it fucking better than me. Concise. I like it. That could be fun. I hope so. I want to get away from a desk. I don't like 9-to-5 jobs, and I don't want to work for anyone else because I've done that before and I hated it. I thought to myself, like, for work-life balance and overall happiness, it's kind of cliche, but if you did something you loved, you'd never have to work another day in your life, some shit like that. Every day Malin goes to work, even on stressful days. He loves what he does. He's proud of what he does. He loves his coworkers. He is very, very proud of his career. My career, while I made really good money, I hated it. I hated what I did. I wasn't proud of it. I didn't like the people I worked with. I only stayed in my career for as long as I did because the money was good. But when Lena was born, I had to choose between my family and my career. I chose my family. And so I gave up my career, and my blood pressure thanks me for it because I was fucking going down some dark places. My career was extremely stressful. And so now that I'm taking a break, being a stay-at-home mom, I'm redoing a reset, a hard reset. And now, if and when I do go back into the working world, I do not want to be a stay-at-home mom for the rest of my life. Fuck that shit. So if and when I go back into the world, I need to pick a new career. And I'm trying to figure out what I'm good at. And I think this is what I'm good at. If I was an old retired lady, what would I do all day? I'd fucking cook and hang out in my garden and garden. That's really the two things I love most, is cooking and gardening. So I don't want to turn cooking into a career, so I'm going the gardening route. All right, what are we looking at? Ooh, nudes throwing down with bone marrow tomato pasta. Holy panda crackers. How did you get a bone marrow tomato pasta? I love the idea of incorporating bone marrow into anything because it's got a lot of flavor, it's good for you, and it's got a lot of flavor. Let's go. My mouth hurts. Why does your mouth hurt, Kiwi? That could be fun. A garden that absorbs the rainwater rather than just letting it run down the street. Yes. So that is one of my plans. So I can go on about this forever, but the short and sweet answer is doing rain catchment systems that then turn into drip irrigation systems to water like gardens and stuff like that. And then I would help install raised beds in people's if they wanted to do all of that. Also, the thing I'm doing in my yard is I'm setting up a pond. So instead of pools, I'm trying to promote recreational ponds or like koi ponds. And the way that it works is that the water gets filtered by being pumped into a wetland system, like a bog. And then the bog has like layers of gravel and plants on top. And it's more of a natural filtration system. So the fish's feces and stuff will actually provide food and nutrients for the plants to grow, and in turn the plants will filter out the water. So the company that I like is called Aquascape, and they have these whole like ecosystem ponds, and I'm putting one of them in my backyard, and then I'm actually going to do a couple other ones. They also have a waterfall or a rain catchment system. So yes, my house, I'm converting my outside to do rain catchment systems for drip irrigation for my raised beds. And I'm installing a eco-friendly ecosystem 20-foot pond in my backyard that will attract frogs and other things like that. I'm also going to hire an apiarist to put a beehive on the corner of my property. And then those beehives will pollinate all of my fruit trees because I got a lot of fruit trees. And then in return, the apiarist will give me hopefully a little bit of honey. For allowing them use of my property. So my whole house is going to turn into a gardener's heaven is my goal. And then when people see my gardens, I also host a lot of gardening clubs and gardener meetups because I'm really into gardening. And so ideally all the gardeners would see my yard, really, really like it, and they would hire me as a landscaper consultant to help them with their yard. That's the plan. But yeah, I fucking hate yards where it's just a bare ass lawn and use tons of fertilizers and chemicals and shit to have this like flat green boring lawn that you never use. Because guess what, we have a flat green boring lawn we never use. So I am doing a bunch of shit to make it a more beautiful, peaceful oasis in our backyard. And then when everyone likes my yard, then I will help them make one in their yard too. Oh, we were closer to bulk cooking. I was making stock. The bones had marrow I didn't want to waste. Ah, gotcha, 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 gotcha. I know what that's like. Sounds good. Braces. Ouch. Braces is why your mouth hurts. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. I hope it recovers. I hope you don't have them on too long. My friend had braces, but she had the ones where the things were on the inside of her teeth. So you didn't see them on the outside? Is that weird? I don't know anyone else who had braces, but hers were on the inside. Strange. Make sure rainwater collection is legal in Seattle. Last I remember, it was not. So it depends. Yes, there are some restrictions on rainwater. I did look into it. Yes. There is ways to do it where it is legal. But yeah, King County is a little bit weird about that. Symbiotic relationships between plants and animals. Yes, that is my plan. Thank you, Retro. Why is it illegal? It rains a lot here. Runoff. They're worried that if a lot of people do rainwater runoff collection, that it's going to mess up the way that they have stuff planned. However, there's actually a rebate in, if you live in actual Seattle, like Seattle area, not one of the suburbs, Seattle will give you a rainwater rebate. So if you do collect rainwater, you get like a fucking big ass rebate of something. Like you save money on your monthly water bill or something like that. So they actually encourage rainwater collection in some parts of King County. And then in other parts, it is legal, but under certain circumstances only. Yeah, it is. It's a little tricky here. That's so much crap. Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with just the terrain and how much it rains here and other shit. So they're careful about how people do it. That is how it is. That sucks. You would think that they would want people to go green and eco-friendly. Rainwater collection is. Yeah, there's the reason why they do what they do. It's not just to be a dick. But they do allow rainwater collection. You just have to follow specific rules so that you don't fuck it over for the city. Or regulated heavy areas, they regard you capturing rainwater as taking away from their power in oversight and waterways. Wow, totally skipping chat. I am skipping chat because it's going to get political. And I'm trying to, when people start getting borderline political, I'll skip it. I'm reading it though, but I just want to be careful. All right, so this is Kuriko, who is also known as Lin J here on Twitch. This is her braised pork butt. Oh my God, that looks amazing. Shit, this is exactly my style of eating. So start with the easy thing. So that's just a white rice with furikake on it, which I love furikake. Fucking braised pork belly. I love pork belly. Oh my God, my mouth is just filled with saliva. This is pickled cucumber or pickled daikon radish and carrots. Super good. I believe Lin J is Vietnamese as well. So that makes sense. I mean, any of us Asians will still make pickled daikon and carrots, but yeah, I think that's one of her favorite things for a side dish. And then a very delicious salad in the background, which to me, given the rest of the food, I'm guessing that is a mayo, sesame oil, soy sauce, and some sort of like chili sauce flakes or something. I make a very similar dressing that looks very similar on a bed of spring greens like that too. You missed my non-lesbo. In government regulation, wait, what was the one? In government regulation heavy areas, they regard capturing. Yeah, what was the one before that though? Armageddon. That's one reason why. Oh, that's one thing that's offered for me. I currently own a townhome 10 minutes out of Fort Worth. But ideally, I want a balance of urban living and having a multi-acre property that I can garden in. You're right. I totally missed that. I'm sorry. I currently live in a townhome 10 minutes away from Fort Worth. Okay. So very city-heavy area. But ideally, I want a balance of urban living and having a multi-acre property that I can garden. Why does it need to be multi-acre? I live on a third of an acre, and I feel like there's more than enough gardening space. Even with my big-ass pond taking up half the backyard, I still feel like a third of an acre is plenty of room to garden on, especially if you get into vertical gardening and succession gardening. But props to you for the multi-acre. That sounds like a lot of work. Yeah. I think I get my ass kicked by my third acre. I don't know what I'd do with anything bigger. I want pork belly. Yes. And meat in general, but I will break my bra. Oh, I want pork belly and meat in general, but it will break my braces. Really, Kiwi? You can't have any meat with braces? That's unfortunate. That really sucks. Holy panda crackers. Blondie throwing down as Blondie does with a Cumberland sausage, mustard infused mash, onion gravy, and roasted veggies. What on earth? Oh, it's a, okay. So the Cumberland sausage, I thought this was a fucking mushroom. This is a sausage and it's curved. I fucking thought that was a giant portobello mushroom. Does it not look like a portobello? Okay, my bad. Okay. Cumberland sausage is this big ass curved thing here. Mustard infused mash must be inside the Cumberland sausage, because I saw these little stringy bits and I thought they were, I thought that was just onions, but I think there's a mash in there. Onions, gravy, and roasted veggies. Obviously the roasted veggies are over here. Nicely done, Blondie, as always. Looks super good. That's fair. I grew up on a family property with 30 acres. That makes a lot of sense. Okay. So yeah, Malin is the same way. Malin really wants to have a lot of property. He didn't grow up on 30 acres. He only grew up on 15, but 15 is still a lot of acreage. I grew up in mostly tiny, tiny houses. So the idea of growing up on acres is kind of mind-boggling to me. But yeah, makes sense. If you grew up with a lot of land, it's kind of like your jam. That rhymed. I don't like neighbors. 2.5 acres. Yeah, 2.5 acres means you don't have anyone all up in your grill. Very nice, very nice. Yes, I just got them yesterday. Oh, kiwis, freshly new with the braces. Well, good luck with them. I've never had them before. My husband's had them like 3 times. So yeah, I know nothing about what you're going through, but I wish you the best of luck. All I've heard is they kind of hurt in the beginning and they get better. There it is. I thought it was a mushroom too. Okay, Mary Todd, thank you. Have you thought about doing aquaponics setup? Yeah, Frozen, I was thinking about aquaponics. Malin was not super big on it. In a sense, the koi pond that I want to put in the backyard with the wetland filter is, in a sense, kind of like aquaponics. Only when you do aquaponics, you're growing more like vegetables and foods that you're going to eat usually off the fish. But the basic setup is very similar. It's just the stuff that's on the wetland filter will be like, I don't know, like a hydrangea or something like that instead of cabbage or watercress. Yeah. Though there will be some, there are some edible plants that will be in the koi pond, like watercress. And there's another water-loving edible vegetable thing that I'll be growing. I definitely am going to be growing lots of food as well. But an actual like indoor aquaponics setup, Malin was not thrilled about it. And I was thinking about growing tilapia as well, because I know one of the YouTubers that I follow, she grows tilapia in her recreational pond that they swim in as a family. There's tilapia in there too. And she put that in there because she wants to, they're really fast, so they're hard to catch. But she wanted to be able to like go out in the back pond, scoop up a tilapia and then fry it up for dinner. I think she's pretty cool. All right, moving on. Alice said, today I made a dish that I named Soup at Kitchen's End. She did this yesterday. It has chicken thighs, mushrooms, carrots, onions, purple potatoes, chicken bone broth, coconut cream, lemon juice, garlic powder, rosemary, oregano, thyme, powdered pepper, arbol, salt and pepper. She's so cool. When Alice cooks, especially like right now when she was winging something, she had no idea what she was going to make for stream. She just kind of winged it as she went. But because she wanted to be able to provide a recipe later on, she like wrote it down as she was making it. Dude, mad props. I am not capable of that. But mad props to her. And yeah, I think it turned out really well. I grew up on 300 acres for 15 years. I don't know what I would do with 300 acres. That's a lot of land. It's a lot of land. All right, Nude's throwing down. Ooh! Well, this looks like a fancy freaking treat. It's like better than a Valentine's Day box of chocolates. Nude's saying, these has been keeping me sane yesterday and today. Box one is creme brulee and passion fruit cream pie donut Nutella red velvet. So, I think that's this corner, right? Creme brulee and passion cream pie donut. And then this one, I think, is the Nutella red velvet one. And then box two is a slice of chocolate caramel cake. Pretty sure that's this one right here. Oh, chocolate caramel fudge cake. Pretty sure that's what that is. And then box three and four. Okay, we'll skip to box five. Box five is roasted garlic flatbread. I like that she got some little roasted garlic flatbread, and that looks like Asiago or Parmesan shredded on top. Very nice. And then these ones. So boxes 3 and 4 are Padang Kaya cheese, raspberry ripple, triple Milo, Snickers, and salted caramel, little tiny cupcakes. I think they're tiny little cupcakes. Yes? Yeah, we're going to go tiny little cupcakes. Were you alluding to a satanic cabbage? Wink, wink. Thank you, Shelberto. Cilantro is numbs. I love cilantro. Hydroponics needs more attention than you think, says Armageddon. When they are adult plants, it's hard to take a week vacation with how much water they take. Yeah, so that's why I'm going with the outdoor pond, because the way the pond will be set up, it's extremely low maintenance. And you should feed the koi on occasion, or like, you know, have someone come and feed the koi every now. But the koi can go for a while without eating, especially because if there's a lot of algae and other stuff built up, they eat the algae is like a lot of snacks. They just snack all day on the algae, and then you feed them too. But in general, lucky for me, I don't really travel that often. So I won't be gone for a week vacation very often. Like, I've not gone on a week vacation in 6 years. Yeah, I don't travel very much. And if I do, my brother lives one street over, and he fucking loves gardening too. So my brother will come over, feed the fish, and do shit if I need him to. But I don't vacation very often. Like, yeah. So we should be good. What's up, Alex? How are you? Welcome in. How's Joe? Nice to see you. Ariga says, I know. I tried in my garage. No, it wasn't weed. What did you grow in your aquaponic setup? What I would do for what I would be excited, I was watching Doomsday Preppers. I like the ones where they have the tilapia on the bottom, and then he grew like all sorts of cabbage and kale and broccoli and all his dark leafy greens and multiple other types of greens. He grew that on top, and I thought that was kind of cool. And he had like, I heard the water evaporation was the only problem with his large elaborate setup, was because obviously they're like, you're gonna lose some of the water that the fish are living in due to evaporation. And if you're in a zombie apocalypse or an emergency situation and you need to top off that water and you don't have a reliable source of thousands of extra gallons of water, that can be a problem. But for the most part, he had a pretty legit setup. All right, next up is Aspie. Woo, Aspie knows how to cook a steak. Kiwi says, no, I'm done. Arg, I want all of this, but I can barely eat noodles. I don't even chew noodles. Kiwi, I'm so sorry. I hope you have like a smoothie or some sort of something snacky. In general, the number one rule to all food and drink streams is to always have snacks, especially on Thursdays when we are listening to our toddler yell in the other room. Especially on Thursdays when we do these field trip. If anyone doesn't know what we're doing right now, exclamation point Discord. In our Discord, we have a channel called Food Picks. And people just throw down food porn all week long. Stuff they're eating, stuff they're making. And then every Thursday on stream, right around 10 p.m., we go on a field trip and we just look at what everyone's making. We have a cocktail. And then we just look at food porn. Ask me throwing down with a butter and garlic basted pepper steak. Ho, 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 let's go. Butter basted steaks, oh, so good. Butter and garlic basted steaks, even better. Over cheddar and bacon pierogies, oh my God. Used to be my nemesis. I used to be destroyed by pierogies. I made them like 3 times in one stream and they all turned out bad. I think it was the recipe, but pierogies, let's go. Specifically, cheddar and bacon pierogies and a tomato cucumber feta salad with oregano and olive oil for dinner tonight. I love the salad. It's in the cute little heart-shaped bowl. Very nice, beautiful colors. Perfectly motherfucking cooked steak. Look at that steak. Look at that. My favorite is this fatty piece, right? Oh, I would eat the shit out of that fatty piece. That is a beautiful, I would say that's rare. Yeah, I like my steaks black and blue. Medium rare, if I must. I can't tell if he's just screaming or if he's saying mom. But he's not angry. He's just screaming for screaming's sake. All right, we're almost done, and then we're going to head to bed. New vision throwing down with some planning around and boiling. Here's a real bowl of ramen I can officially call mine to show. Tori, Pai Tan ramen with sous vide chicken char siu. Holy shit. chicken char siu. How do you do that? Crunchy cabbage and jammy egg over chewy sun noodles. Holy panda crackers. Nicely done, bro. Your egg is perfect. Your broth, look, egg, perfect. Broth, beautiful. Nice chewy noodles, got some green onions. I'm digging the char siu chicken. I don't have no idea how to even do that. And then, yeah, nice crunchy cabbage. I can't tell if he's yelling at me. It's okay, we're gonna wrap up in a second. I gotta go deal with my toddler who woke up and is now screaming. Nudes throwing down with can you guys hear him? Okay, I'm gonna let you all look at this picture for a second and try to guess what it is, and I'm gonna go see what Jace is screaming about. I'll be right back. My kid is crazy. He wants a jelly sandwich in the middle of the night. So I'm going to make him, we're going to wrap this up. I'm going to make him a jelly sandwich and then we're going to go to bed. What's up, C-Bus? Welcome in. How are you? Welcome, welcome. Nice to see you. Oh God, Jace is yelling. And yes, he is yelling, Mom. Yep, that was definitely Mom. And I was like, what's up? He's like, I want a jelly sandwich and chocolate chips. Normal. It's a normal size cupcakes. Those are big ass cupcakes. I know I tried in my garage. What I tried to grow in my hydroponics was just herbs, green onions, dill, parsley, basil, thyme, and mint. Oh God. Yeah. We're doing our Joe has a cold again. Yeah, Jace is just getting over his, he doesn't have to miss school now though. So it's not really a huge thing. Well, that's good. Ayo, here we go. Yeah. Now he's chanting in tongues. Call the exorcist. Do you have a number for the local exorcist? Cause yeah, hit me up. Was playing some Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Nice. Very cool, C-Bus. You're going to make him a jelly sandwich at midnight? That's how the terrorist wins. Yes, I'm going to make him a jelly sandwich at midnight. He didn't eat a big dinner. I'm not surprised he woke up in the middle of the night because he's probably hungry. All right. Nudes doing bulk cooking begins. The menu of basmati butter, corn rice, daging masak hitam, which is spiced beef cooked in a dark soy. Ooh, yeah, that sounds really good. Quail egg and fishball sambal, which is a sweet, spicy sweet cooked chili paste. And a fresh akar, and mostly for the bento boxes, ayam masak bawang, spiced chicken in an onion gravy. And granny made a bubur putih, bubur merah, birthday sweet and slightly salted layer porridge. Thank you for the translations. All right, so this is mise en place. Very nice. All the things. I won't even try to guess which one's which, but I got that there's like lemongrass in the corner. Woohoo! Next up is, oh, I love all the giant ass pots. Very nice. Lots of pots going on. And this is mixy, mixy, mixy. I like that you have the long metal spoons like that. Very good for all the mixing. Another angle, because you know we like all the different angles. Those are very handy pot heater things to have. Very cool. Very big. Yeah, your kitchen is like an industrial kitchen now. And more foodsies. Ooh, that sauce looks delicious and rich. We got more. Those look like chickpeas. Are they chickpeas? They look like chickpeas. Yummy. I translated that in a hazy sleepy mode. It's not long enough. The translation is way longer. Whoop, whoop, back to our normal view. Gabby, what's up, geek boy? I know. Sorry about last night with the whole power outage. I did not enjoy the phone either. But we're back. We're going to.